Hey guys, it's Chris, and I'm going to show you today. We're going to upgrade on our RPod 2009 171. Did not come with outside speakers, and it's kind of a nice feature to have. So I'll be replacing that today with the new RV Media outdoor speaker kit. For those that don't know this, they're quite expensive, but they're so worth it. They have speakers inside that, and on the bottom you have LED lights, and they have the three primary colors in each LED light, so you can do pretty much any color you want to. It connects Bluetooth to your cell phone, so you can turn the light on and off, put a sleep timer on it, which will turn it off in 15, 20 minutes, whatever you want to do. You can do a strobing effect, going into colors real slow, real fast, which we'll talk about that maybe a little bit later. I believe it's 100 watts per speaker. I plugged it up to the truck just a little while ago, and it sounds really good. I got this one without the mountain brackets. I got it off eBay. This was actually one of their kind of display models, so it didn't come with any brackets. That was fine. You really don't need them. They're optional. So I'm going to show you how I'm going to install it without the brackets, because I got a really good deal on this. I got it for like $125, and I think they're $250 in the store. So I'm going to be putting this on today to upgrade my system. So I'll be probably doing it a little different way than having the mount. So, you know, I just thought I'd give this a good review and kind of show people, you know, how good these things sound and how they match up. So let's get started.
Okay, so the first thing we need to do is get your flathead screwdriver.
And we're going to go ahead and pop
without breaking, which I guess it doesn't matter anymore because you're getting rid of it. As you can see, I changed my bulb out with an LED light. I got an Advanced AutoZone. Get them off eBay, whatever. These work pretty well. They don't overheat. But yeah, we're going to be upgrading this to some better LED lights. So you're going to have two screws, two Phillips, and we're going to be taking them out today. Let me get her. I'm going to use this flathead to probably go ahead and. Actually, no, I'm not. I'm gonna actually use my electric screwdriver. All right, so now I'm gonna take out my Phillips screws with my screwdriver. Okay. Now I've got both the screws loose. I just finished re-caulking this year, so I put a lot of caulk around here. So I'm gonna probably have to go over it and kind of get me a line started and cut around it. Just kind of break the seal so it won't be so hard to pull. Kind of laid a little thick. I'm a little worry wart when I put my caulking on. I want to make sure I still have my leaks. Alright. This again, I may use my flathead screwdriver to do this. I'm going to pry, which will be hard. Like I said, yours probably won't be as difficult, but I've put a lot of sealant on mine. I just finished re-caulking this camper this summer. Alright. Ewy gooey. Yours probably won't be so bad to take off. As you can tell, I've already started removing some of my strips.
Okay,
I've removed all the caulking with my scraper. So it's nice and smooth, so I know it'll do a good seal. Next thing you're going to have is you're going to disconnect your light. You're going to have two wire ties. And they're probably gonna be wrapped with electrical tape, so we need to remove those. So before you remove it, you need to remember what color is what. So right now we have the orange and black, and then we have the white on white. You might have different colors. It depends on, you know, the model of your pod. Just remember those. You're gonna have the ground. The black is always your ground. On a 12-volt system, so this orange is going to be your ground. This white will be your hot, like on a 110.
So let's go ahead and we'll twist one of these off. Keep up with these. You'll be using them again for the light. Okay, so you're gonna have the wires after you take the cap off. Just pull it apart. And make sure you got your outdoor light off before you do that. Should have said that before. Mine is off. So there's no power going through here, so I will not get shot or blow the fuse. It's a 12-volt circuit. It won't kill you, but it sure won't, it's not going to feel good either. And you could, like I said, blow a fuse, maybe damage some your speakers. So try to twist these off one-handed. All right, so I got both caps off. And like I said, orange to ground, white to white. If you'll come down here, you're going to have different colors. You're going to have a black and a red. Usually on a 12-volt, your black's ground, your red's hot. So when we come back here, we'll notice we got black as a ground going to orange. The white is going to be hot. It will connect to red. You're going to have a different pattern, but usually all black on a 12-volt system is ground. So we know this is a 12-volt light. This had ground on it going to the orange, so we knew that was our ground wire. If you're not sure, use a voltage meter. You can kind of test it that way, or get somebody, if you don't understand how to use one of those, get some help for somebody. But that's going to be pretty much how it's going to go. Basically, on this, you're going to have a little plug out. So you basically would wire this in. This has been used before, so like I said, someone already had caps. I will be cutting these wires and attaching it to here, actually, like this. And then I'll be able to plug in my speakers.
I just want to take a second. I don't know how this thing came out of the package brand new, so I'm going to show you what happens if this is a situation. Here's the plug here. Before it had two crimps already on it and had two wires. They may already come pre-stripped. They may not. For those that's never done it, you can use a carpet knife. Wire strippers would be easier, but if you don't have them, you got to make do with what you got. You can use a pocket blade, something like that. You just basically want to take your wire, be real careful not to cut yourself, and just kind of cut it, but not go real hard on it because you don't want to cut the wires. You just want to cut the rubber around it, and you kind of just want to get all the way around it. Let's see here. Just lightly, just to cut your rubber. All the way around, and just kind of should be able to grab it and pull it loose. Okay, once you do that, make sure you twist these wires. This wires right here help it get it better connected. Okay, so I am ready now to attach it to the camper. Okay, so I've already done my hot wire. It doesn't matter which one you do first. Basically, we use the existing wing nut. These things just twist on, and I'm going to show you how to do one of them. You're going to take your nut, and if yours for some reason didn't have this, the wing nut's already onto your wire, just go buy you some at Lowe's. You just need the real small ones. Basically, what you want to do, and you'll probably have more wire in this. Like I said, this is used, so keep in mind. This is a little bit bigger gauge wire because it ran a lot longer through the camper than what this wire was. So you want to take both wires, kind of want to twist it together till it looks like that, just enough. And then you're going to put your cap on top of it. Now as you put your cap, it's got grooves, and you're going to turn it clockwise, counterclockwise to take them off, clockwise to turn them on. And it's going to start taking hold and gripping it, it's going to start threading, and you keep doing it till it gives you some resistance until it don't do it anymore, and then it's going to be on there. The next step is we're going to wrap this up with electrical tape. So I'm going to take the reason we use this electrical tape, it doesn't have to have it, but I would strongly recommend it to anybody, because if the wire ever gets pulled, if you're doing any work on this and it gets pulled or anything like that, it'll help these wires not pop out. And it was on there previously, and we're going to put it right back the way it was. You will probably have more wire to play with than what I did. Like I said, I got this unit used, so it had already been crimped once.
You don't have to go crazy with the tape. You just kind of want to, in case one of those wires has a possibility of popping out, it's not going to touch anything and ground anything out. Save your fuse, because this fuse may be connected to your inside lights and then everything's dead, and every time you put a fuse in, it'll blow it. This way, might save you getting through the night.
All right. So basically,
we take our speakers, and there was weather stripping that comes with the package. Mine already had it already stuck on there previously. You'll have to go ahead and make your little box design. I liked what they done. They made one big strip, then they made another strip, and one big long strip. Because rain will use coming through this direction, splash up through this direction, and just maybe probably on this side here going down the road. So if you try to make as tight as you can, because when it's pushed, it's going to flatten these guys to make that seal up. So you want to make your seals as tight as possible, so when it pushes against the wall, you won't have to worry about water. If you feel like you need to caulk after you get this thing set up and you want to pre-caulk it, I mean, that's understandable. I probably might do that myself. So you're just going to take your barrel pin and plug it in. Now, right now, I am going to turn on the power and see if I have power to my speakers. I currently do not. Before you mount it, I always check. So, why don't I? Good question. I probably may not have a good connection on these, so I'll have to take it off and redo it again. So, stand by. Okay, guys, I wanted to show you something real quick. To take off your fuse box, you'll take this screw and loosen it. It'll help you a lot to change the fuse box. What you need to do is probably find out what amp breaker. There was one that just said 415 bathroom, and underneath it says porch light. And if you'll notice, the porch light is a 515. I will now take my panel off. And as you notice, I have an orange light right here. The reason I don't have a fuse in it, so that's why I got the red light. So that is definitely, and I have the porch light on right now, so it went off when I pulled the fuse. So that's how I determined that was the one for me. So I'm going to, that is definitely my hot wire for my speaker. All right, putting the fuse back in. We're good to go. So you have to be careful. You kind of might just find it, pull your fuse, make sure it powers down. You know, that's it. Look, see what color wire you have, and that's going to be your hot wire. So let's get back to the light. Hey guys, the reason the speakers didn't work, I blew a fuse. I always check with a voltage meter, which I didn't do. I was wrong on the wiring. It was actually, the orange wire was hot, the white wire was ground. So when I swapped them, we got lights now, we got power. Good news is my fuse caught it before it hurt my speakers. Another way, if you don't know how to use a voltage meter, you could look and see if you saw the orange wire. You will see it in your breaker box next to your fuses. All your fuses will have a wire that's screwed in. None of them should be white. You should see an orange one, be like, oh, well, yeah, if I see an orange one or whatever color your two wires are, look to see that color. That's probably a good indication that's your power, your lead. But yeah, I had it backwards. So now that I got that straightened out, I'm gonna retape it, and then we'll get to mounting this. As mounting it, I didn't get any mounting screws at all, so I chose two shorter ones on the top. These are probably an inch. The other ones are 1.5 at the bottom. And the reason I did that is because on these holes, the ones on the top actually sunk in a little bit more, or actually come out a little bit more than the bottom was because of the bracket. I know I have some clearance, but I just didn't. I want to be safe than sorry. So I used two different types of screws. So the next step
is going to be find out where you want to mount it. I'm going to mount it probably about right here. After that, I'll be tucking my wire back in and that jazz, and then mount my screw.
Okay, something that I realized is I had to make a couple more drill holes and actually make this a little deeper, because I want to be able to push these nuts and these wires back into that hole, so it'll, you know, be, you know, it'll be able to connect a little bit flatter. You know, I had to use a drill bit for metal, wall it out a little bit, so it'd go in that track. Another thing I did is I took the electrical duct tape and I taped the barrel pin. That way it wouldn't get pulled apart. If you're going down the road, it could fall out very easily. So now I will be pushing my wires back up in there, and then should be ready.
Okay, I got my wires, barrel plug and everything pushed in there, flat. So next thing that I need to do is just mount it.
Okay, so as you can see, my holes that I drilled to push all the wiring back, I actually used a little, you know, some RV caulking that I had left over from a previous project, and covered up the hole nice and well. That way, if there's any water leaks, it'll get right, this will kind of stop it from getting inside the camper.
Now, as you can tell by the way they dug my hole out for my light, it's going to be right up against my seal. So that caulking will actually help the water not get inside. So depending on where your hose at, that's as far as I can get over to the door with it out, you know, to lay flat. So that's why I'm glad I used the caulking.
Okay, so I got my light mounted. I checked it with a level, make sure my camper's level is pretty level enough. Got it on there. And I used my three, four screws, and it sealed up better on this side than it did on the other side. That's probably because the hole it had, but I checked up above it, and it seems to be sealing pretty good. So I think we're good to go. Still got power, things are looking good. Okay, so let me, I'm gonna run a beam of caulk. I just don't trust that I'm going to run a beam of caulk all the way around it. So stay tuned. Okay, guys. I got it mounted. I ran my caulk all the way around it, so help protect it. So the next thing is I'm going to go in here. I'm going to flip my switch. When it first comes on, it'll sit there and try to search. You can tell by the two lights here, it'll sit there and search for your device that you're connected to. Now, I've already connected my phone, but I have not connected. I got the Bluetooth turned off because I wanted you to see what it'll do when it's trying to pair to your Bluetooth device. So after it sits there and tries to find your device that you've already connected to, it'll give up in a minute, and both of these lights will start blinking back and forth just like they are right now. This is the time you sync, and it'll connect right up. You sync any device you want to. So let me show you what happens.
Okay,
when you
so I've killed it.
I turn back my switch. All right, it's gonna sit there and search for my phone. Boom. You got a steady light. I mean, your phone's connected. So the next thing I do is I'm gonna play a little bit of music through it.
Okay, so now we're gonna do a sound check. I'm using my other phone to play some music. Let's see what happens.
So far, I'm good. Pretty good sound. And it's annoying. I'm going to turn it up. So, not bad. Not bad at all. Let's try another song.
Let's see if we can find us a good song.
Wise folks count their blessings, fools count their problems.
Not a bad sound.
gotta admit, she's sounds really loud. Let me stand a little farther back. That's halfway. If I turn her up, this is loud as she'll go.
She grew up in Indiana town.
That's pretty freaking loud, actually. That's full blast on my cell phone. This is with the Bluetooth. Now, probably what I'm going to do, this is an OG 3GS iPhone. I'll probably charge it up and use it in the camper to control my music, but it won't control the light because the software's too old to update for the RV. So it's probably my music player, and if I want to change it, I'll change it with the phone. So, yeah, this thing didn't wind up turning about being a really bad deal. like I said, I got it for $125. It worked out pretty good, and I'm pleased with it. So I will leave the lights on tonight and kind of let it run for a while, and we'll see how the battery drains. Okay, thanks. So as you can see, this is the white light. It covers a lot better than the original light. It's just amazing how much better it does. If I want to turn off the light, there's a button right here that I can just click and it's off. The little RV media sign does light up a little, and you'll have these little lights. You click it back on, you're back. So here's an idea of what it's gonna look like outside. When you turn your light off, it'll take a minute to power down. Turn it on. A lot of brightness, man. This thing is killer. That's a lot more light than the original light. Now I've let this thing run with the LED lights on without the music playing, but it still should power that amp. So the light's been running probably about 4 or 5 hours now, and I checked my battery results. Still showing a full charge. So it doesn't seem to be draining the battery a whole lot. I'm going to probably leave it on all night tonight and see what happens, see how much of a drain of the battery it actually uses. The only thing that concerns me a little bit is the thing has an amp that powers the speakers that's 100 watts a piece. So my question is how much of a drain on the battery is it? So I'll find that out tomorrow. So just something I just recently found out, that it doesn't matter when you bring the app what color you make it. Like right now, I have it to a blue. As soon as I come over here to my switch and I turn the lights off and it powers down, and I come back over here and turn on my switch, it goes automatically to bright white. So it doesn't save the that you're actually set it on. So if you want it to go to bug light, you got to change it, which white is the brightest color, so it's going to definitely show a lot better around, but it's not going to save the bug light. You have to actually change it with the app to the bug light. So that's something you need to think about. Okay, so I've ran the light and the speakers playing music all night
from 6:30 p.m. until 7:23 a.m.
So let's see where the battery's at. That's not bad. That's running it all night. So this thing doesn't consume as much power as you think. Let's go to my voltage meter. Let's see what it says. 12.5. So, yeah, so she doesn't drain as much power as I thought she would.
Okay, so guys, this is the app that you're going to use for this. You'll download it from the Apple Store, or it's called RV Media. And pretty much, when you sync up your phone to it and download this app, and it's going to come up at first, and it's, if you've already connected to Bluetooth, it's going to show the device,
So you're going to click on it, and it's going to come with a cool screen. Now, if you click on white, it's going to stay white. So if you'll notice, there's my, I'll show you what's going to happen is I'm going to go to red, goes to red. Go to blue, goes to blue. White, white. So you can adjust whatever color you want. If you want to do like a funky green or a yellow, it'll show it. So let me show you a couple other cool features. You can also hit the button here. Turn the light off. Turn it back on. Also, let's just go with the bright. The light is so much brighter, and I'll get outside in just a second. The light is so much brighter than the porch light that it's originally styled on the original R-Pod. So the cool part is you have a couple more options. When you slide this wheel side to side and make it go around, it'll get darker where you can hardly even see anything. So that's a really cool feature. And you make it as bright as you want to. So that's kind of neat. You have a couple of things here. Like I got it set to a sleep timer in 5 minutes. So that means the whole porch light will go off. There's also an insect. As soon as you click it, it'll go into insect mode, which is a yellow. As soon as you click on color scan, it'll go through all the different colors. So I'm going to step outside real quick so you can take a better look at this. Sorry, I was sitting in my truck. I waited to film this at night. I don't know if this camera can pick it up as well. So that's my review for the RV Media speakers LED light system. I like it. It's better on battery life, brighter light, really good sound. I definitely recommend it for anybody that doesn't have outdoor speakers, or maybe they want to upgrade their outdoor speakers. It's an easy way to do it. So if you got any questions or anything, just please hit me up and I'll see if I can help you install it. Thanks for watching.